Okay, I do have instructions for you and you. So at the end of the puppet show, you are all disciples, the disciples, and a song will show up there, and you will sing it. And when the kids all jump up, you will too. Or at least raise your hands. Okay. Buenos dias, boys and girls. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hi, kids. Hi, Barnabas. Hi, Pepe. It's good to see everyone here this morning. Happy Easter.
Hi, everyone. Happy Easter from me, too. So, let's get down to it.
Right. I want to buy a vowel.
What?
I want to buy a vowel. You know, A, E, I, O, and U. And sometimes Y. Unless you're speaking Welsh, and then it's almost always Y.
What are you talking about? It's Easter Sunday, the highest holy day of the year for the church. And we're here to celebrate Easter, the risen Jesus. And you're playing Wheel of Fortune.
I like Wheel of Fortune.
Well, I like diving into a river in the morning to grab my breakfast. But I'm not doing that up here in the baptismal font in the church on Easter Sunday.
Or ever, I hope.
I know, but I was thinking.
Not recommended.
I was thinking last night while watching Wheel of Fortune, it's been on 35 years, and it's exactly the same. Same host, same smiles, same alphabet. Well, it made me feel, I don't know, calm. This world, life, is so complicated and stressful. But when I'm watching that show, everything seems more simple and relaxed. More relaxed than real life is. I've been so stressed out in school with homework and high performance expectations when doing show and tell. And I just want to buy a vowel.
Barnabas, of course life is more complicated than a game show. Because life isn't just about being simple or relaxed.
What's it about then?
It's about meaning, which you don't get from a game show.
What do you get there then?
Escape.
I still want to buy a vowel. A comfort vowel. Look, I got the whole alphabet here from my play along at home with Vanna version of the cane.
Oh, all right, hurry up then so we can get on with it. So, which vowel?
Let's see. I know. How about a U? And look, with this, I can help solve today's puzzle. Watch this. What is it?
Jesus.
It is. It's Jesus!
Well, that's great, Barnabas. So, now can we get on with it, with the Easter story? Alright, so speaking of life and being stressed out, as the Bible tells us, on the night before that very first Easter, the disciples were totally stressed out. They felt lost and forlorn. And comfortless. Jesus, their master, their teacher, Jesus the Messiah, come to save them all, had been crucified and his body put in a tomb. They didn't know what to do. All they could do was cry.
They had no idea what was going to happen to them, to everyone. They had had such great plans, but Jesus had been taken by the Romans and he was gone.
And so, just to do something that morning on the third day, Mary Magdalene, went to the tomb. cry some more. But when she got there, something was weird. The stone at the front of the tomb had been rolled away. What did it mean? So she ran back and got two more of the disciples, and then they ran back and looked in and saw something that changed the world. The tomb was empty.
Why?
I need to buy another vowel.
Okay, tell that vowel.
Wait, Barnabas, now? Are you kidding?
No, really. I really need an O.
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, it's a wow.
Wowza.
Well, okay, as I was saying, the disciples looked in, and they saw that the tomb was empty.
Thank you. Quiet nights and quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar, floating on the silence that surrounds us. Quiet thoughts and quiet dreams, quiet walks by quiet streams, climbing hills where lovers go to watch the world below. Together we will live eternally in this mood of revelry, far from all the earth.